नित्यानंदं परमसुखदं केवलं ज्ञानमूर्तिं द्वंद्वातीतं गगनसदृशं तत्वमस्याधिलक्ष्यं एकं नित्यं विमलमचलं सर्वदी साक्षीभूतं भावातीतं त्रिगुणरहितं सद्गुरुं तं नमामि। प्लीज हम द महावाक्य विद मी विल बी हमिंग इट थ्राइस विद योर बैक स्ट्रेट। Some of the other shaktis. Many of you will have seen one thing. The moment you finish a certain power 21 times, your idea about you, the shakti, Swamiji, idea about others is changing. How many of you are actually feeling that things are changing when you do the 21 times? Raise your hands. Just look around you without dropping your hands. Are we understanding? This is the power of being able to, what Swamiji says, he'll make it happen. All we have to do is play. Problem is, we have got a problem with playing. Maybe because in childhood, when you're continuously playing, people try to put a time on it. And here we are telling, play all night. Forget everything else, keep playing. So for many adults, I always notice when they come in, it feels like, why are we not talking about the problems? Understand? Instead, everyone's just saying, play, I've got heart trouble. But your heart trouble will go away when you're manifesting a pulse change. When you do it 21 times and see dramatic increases, her pulse had dropped to 30. Dr. Peter Bloomfield is saying she should be like dead any minute. But she's laughing there. Swamiji said, when you continuously play with the Shakti, you will be able to have the power of being able to just stop your pulse. When the pulse stops, heart also stops. Then you will know there is no gap between you and Swamiji. No gap between you and what you call as a cosmic divinity, Sadashiva. When the gap happens between you and Sadashiva, that is when all this humanness, emotions taking over us happens.
See, I'll just finish the whole thing in 2-3 statements. You are a hardware, this body. And thus, there is a software. The programming, which operates this body. There is an electricity connection. Now, the software with which you were operating and the electricity, these two is completely screwed up. That is when the hardware also started getting destroyed. I am doing two things. One, again and again putting the powerful software. See, every powerful cognition I am giving you, like a this static matter, dynamic activity, strategic existence is one and the same. And immediately, till you get into your old stupid screwed software, you will not have doubt. For a few minutes, because of my face value, I think this fellow must be telling only for my good. Some reason, it will be there as alive memory. Those few minutes when you decide to use that as your software, my super consciousness, my electricity connects with you. Not the regular electricity with which you are working, bioenergy. No, Sadashiva's bioenergy. Who gave me the experience and authority to transmit this experience, his bioenergy just enters into you. Once you start seeing that moving, you will feel, oh God, I think this fellow is right. Once 21 times you move, then this software cannot be taken out of your software. How many of you are understanding what I am saying? Understand? That's all is the whole game. It's all, see, the whole program is nothing but, I want to give you some 60-70 powerful cognitions. You are the consciousness, you cannot be killed. See, all the books Hinduism has 2 crore source books. All of you need to know, Hinduism has 2 crore source books. For Christianity, only 1 source book, Bible. For Islam, only 1 source book, Quran. For Buddhism, only 1 source book, Dhammapada. Hinduism has 2 crore source books. The whole 2 crore source book. And we have more than 1 crore temples. And almost billion followers. And at least I can say 10 million enlightened beings have lived on the planet Earth because of Hinduism. People who become enlightened because of Hinduism. And the chain is still alive, a living stream of Hinduism. Essence of all this is the 70 powerful cognitions. That's all. Once the 70 powerful cognition starts operating in you, you are the consciousness. These are all the side effects of the remaining. Listen carefully. When you understand you are the consciousness and you declare that as your powerful cognition, I am the consciousness. So, my ups, downs, mood swings, ideas, identities, which comes and goes, none of this can be my real cognition. As a side effect, many of the disturbed, screwed up software stops working. Means they all get slowly deleted. The whole Hinduism or the spiritual science in the world is this only. 60 to 70 roughly powerful cognitions should manifest in you as powers, not just intellectually. If you just get intellectually, you will never believe. It is like a working on the mind. Working on the mind is equivalent to trying to change your spouse. try. Working on the mind is waste of time. I am telling you, if you have been working on mind, or gurus who are teaching you to work on your mind and you are doing that, please be informed, you will end up only in frustration. I have seen enough of fellows working on mind. It's a failure. Be very clear. Because mind is non-existent screenplay of the hormones and chemicals in the body. Understand, when Buddha says nothing exists, he talks about mind only, not about the consciousness. One young brahmachari goes to a very senior 90-year-old monk and asks, "Oh Swami, how long it takes to control the mind?" He says, "I do not know how long, but till 90 it doesn't happen." I am telling you, if you are working on Vedanta, if you are working on mind, that is what is the truth. See, Hinduism has only two traditions. Only two traditions. One works on consciousness, another one works on body. That's all. We never worked on mind. Because we know from the beginning it doesn't exist. Work on biology. Allow the super consciousness to give a breakthrough. People ask me many times, oh Swamiji, in other ashrams, in other organizations, in other systems, we work for 5 years, 6 years to have a small experience. How come we are manifesting powers here? Is it all magic or is it real, real, really, really real? If you are working in the wrong direction, why will you not waste your life? All working on mind is working on wrong direction. It's like you can go to Bangalore this way or this way. If you go this way, you will come after 25 years, rounding the whole earth. If you go this way, you will come in 25 minutes, that's all. Working on the mind is going this way. Working on the body is the real thing. Now, even when I give you powerful cognitions, I am not working on your mind, I am working on your consciousness. I am educating your consciousness, that's the right word. I am just making you ferocious. Making you understand the mind is the chain. One beautiful thing, if you start tasting freedom of one powerful cognition in reality, like a few powers, suddenly the taste for that powers makes you ferocious and you start breaking the patterns. You even start forgetting you had addictions. Sometimes not only you walk out of addictions, you forget you had addictions. You had those problems. So the whole gist is, again and again inserting powerful cognitions, even while you are dealing in your day-to-day life, before dealing it, insert a powerful cognition. I am consciousness. I have a superiority over everything exists around me. Everything exists around me is my decision. It is not arrogance. Please understand, it's not arrogance. It's not arrogance. Insert that software and bring oneness. And I am giving you this consciousness, this cognition. If you do something right or wrong and all that, I am responsible, don't worry. You just go ahead. I am responsible. Start rolling your inner space with powerful cognitions. Once the power manifestation becomes like a lifestyle, like a flow of your very being, the kind of a inner image you will start cherishing, you will actually bless yourself. You will feel so happy to live in your body. You will feel so happy to live with you. You will feel so blessed to be who you are. End of the day, that is the result I wanted. Not just, see, all these are great, no doubt. But end result is that only. You feeling blessed with yourself. It's powerful cognitions, that's a result. Power manifestation is a side effect. Power manifestation is a side effect of powerful cognitions. That's all is the essence of the whole program. The essence of what I am doing, I have spoken. Now you come up with your questions. What do you want to ask? Or your anything else you want to tell? Come on. We will have small talks now. Come on.
Hi, Swamiji. Actually, I heard you a couple of days ago. You said that all power manifestation happens as a result of nirvikalpa samadhi or oneness or enlightenment. So while doing any kind of power manifestation over here, I am not able to feel any kind of internal subjective experience that is leading to
See, fundamentally you work with multiple fractured softwares. When you work with your dad, you have a separate software. When you work with your mom, you have a separate software. When you work with your father, the friends, you have a separate software. You are multiple fractured softwares. Now I am putting one software of oneness to do power manifestation. It is too small compared to the load which is around you. You are so comfortable in playing with all those softwares. It takes little time for this new software. After it manifests powers, it starts influencing all the other softwares. Then in few days, it makes all the other irrelevant, redundant. Then this overpowers and makes you, that oneness becomes your fundamental cognition where you park yourself. Till then, I go on supporting you, holding you in me. Understand? That is why, even if you don't feel, you are made to manifest powers so that you will have confidence on the software. So that virtuous circle starts happening. See, usually what you do, you don't have confidence on this truth. So the confidence does not manifest as power. It's a vicious circle. Here, I am infusing the energy and make you manifest the power. That gives you confidence on the software, and confidence gives more power. More power gives more confidence. It becomes virtuous circle. Pushing your life from vicious circle to virtuous circle is the job of the guru. That's the job of the guru. And supporting you, holding you during this push and making sure you are successful is my job. Yes. This side also, you can come up to mic and...
That kind of answered my question.
All right. Then great.
Can I go think of another one and come back later?
Yes. You are all free. It's a small talk. There is no restriction. And not only that, it's not just question. If you want to pass a comment, you are free to pass. It's a small talk we are having, and you can ask anything you want.